Hi everyone, it's Vicky here and welcome back. Today I have even more party bugs and I will be playing with a new die set. This is a huge die set and it has just been released by Tonic Studios for their 20th birthday. To celebrate, they have released this mega die set that creates three different gift bags and I'm going to show you each and every one of them. And it comes with 47 dice for a price that is $37.99. I think the price is amazing. In this die set, you will get everything you will ever need to create gift and favor bags. So first, let's take a look at what you get. You will get three basic dice. These are the dice that you need to create your bags. You need to cut out two of each design. So there is the one with a rounded handle at the top. There's this one with a more rectangle handle and notice that they have a different angle on the sides. And the third one is the fancy one, which I absolutely love. This one creates a beautiful tab on top that you can fold over to close the bag. All three of them are really easy to put together. You only have to cut out two panels and glue them together. And I will create all three of them today. Now to decorate front and back as well as the sides, you will find lots and lots of interchangeable panels here. Now you will get the basic dies that cut out panels. You can use them to cut out windows or create panels to stick on top. There are different ones with scalloped edges. There are others with stitched lines or dots all around. And you can flip them over to fit each and every one of those different bag shapes. There are dies that fit inside those main panels to decorate front and back in lovely designs, and you will find similar designs as small rectangles. These are for decorating the sides of your bags. Remember, everything fits in each and every one of those three different bag designs. So with all those dies included, you can mix and match and you can create so many different styles. Now these two dies are for decorating the flap, but again, notice that you get the outside as well as the inside. So you get three different shapes with bigger and smaller scallops or stitched designs. You get the beautiful lace that fits inside. So many different options here. Now there are these dies that cut out little holes. These are if you want to wrap a ribbon or a thread. You get four holes as well. These are triangles that fit on the sides if you want to use those to decorate your bag. Now for embellishing your little bags, you can use this rolled flower die. This is going to end up giving you a lovely flower that you can use on top of your cards, on the flap, on the sides, wherever you want. And I will be using it today. And finally, you will find lots and lots of dies that you can mix and match to create tags and badges. Some of them have rectangle shapes or oval shapes. They have lovely stitching all around, or they do have embossed sayings on top. And I will be using some of them today so you can see how you can mix and match those as well. Here is an oval one, lovely, and remember that you don't have to use these just for your bags. Little labels are always handy to add on your cards or other projects. The kit also includes this fun die that you can add on the sides. And this is going to give you that design where you can squeeze the tops together to close your bag. It's optional, so it depends on the style that you are going for. And I'm going to make both styles so you can see that die in action. For my first bag, I'm going to use the fancy one, the one with the flap on top. You can fit it both ways on top of a standard cardstock, and I'm using here a specialty cardstock. This is by Tonic Studios and it is called Silver Silk. So I have two identical pieces. You don't need one of those top parts, so I'm going to use my scissors and just chop it off. You can use your paper trimmer for that as well. Now the one that doesn't have a flap is going to be your front panel. I'm using my bone folder to fold everything and reinforce the scoring lines. I'm gonna do that for both the die cuts, and this is the part where you need to decorate the front and the back if you want to decorate anything. Since they are completely flat, they are easier to work with. Once you put together the box, it's always difficult. Not that it isn't possible. So for this bag, I decided to cut out a window. I'm going to use one of those beautiful lace-looking designs, and I'm using the one that looks like leaves. And I like the fact that it gives an empty space at the center where you can stick a sentiment. And of course, they give you dies that fit exactly there. Now I'm going to secure it down with some washi tape, run it through my die cutting machine, and here you can see the window. This way you can look inside on the contents of the box. If you feel that the contents are very small and they are going to fall out, you can always stick some acetate at the back to create a little window. Now I'm going to use double-sided tape at the flaps. And for that, of course, you can use your liquid glue. I'm going to use my liquid glue at the bottom of the box, and you will see what I mean, because it makes it easier for me to slide one piece on top of the other. So once I have everything there, I'm going to use my tool and just peel off the backing of that double-sided tape. I first like to fold it on its own at the bottom, reinforce that bonding there with my bone folder. So I have two identical pieces that I can slide one on top of the other. This is where I'm going to place the glue. And all I have to do now is to align them correctly. I already have double-sided tape on the flaps at the sides. Now, since I used such a fancy cardstock, it is really shiny and sparkly, and I think it makes the box look really pretty. So I don't really need to do a lot to decorate it, otherwise it's going to be too much. Now, one way to hold that bag down is to use one of those dies that adds little holes, and I'm going to show you that in another bag later on. So this is where you can place it, or you can just add a couple of holes with your crocodile at the top, tie a ribbon, and you are ready to go. Another way to hold it down is with a magnet, if you want to do that beforehand. And then finally, the third way, and this is the one that I'm going to work with today, is to add the sentiment just a little bit raised. This way you will be able to tuck underneath the flap, and it's going to hold nicely there. I combined two of the dies from the kit to create that lovely tuck at the center, and I used foam tape at the back, so you see the flap is tucked underneath and really easy to open up. I also used the die that cuts out that rolled flower, and I put together a white flower there. I also used a leaf die that I had on my stash to cut out those leaves, just to decorate it a little bit more. And I stayed with white. I don't want to introduce any other color. I think that silver and white make a great combination for really elegant and pretty projects. I also added a few gems at the center of the flower and on my tag. And notice how easy it is to read the tag. It says special wishes and it's just embossed. For my second bag, I'm going to use the die with the rounded handle. Remember, there's another one that is more squared up. I cut it out twice from white cardstock, and now I'm going to create a panel. So I'm combining two of the dies here. The one on the outside creates a lovely scalloped edge, while the other one that looks like a lace creates this beautiful design with lots of flowers and leaves. So I like to work without using too many colors. I don't like to be super busy. So I'm using a Nouveau Deluxe at the back. I'm going to stick this panel on top of the front of my little bag. Then I did a little bit of inlay die cutting, so I cut out the same die from green and pink cardstock, and I placed all those bits and pieces inside. It is a bit time consuming, but it's going to make your little bag look super special. Another way to get a similar look, but super fast, is to just add a panel at the back, which is different color. So I added pink gems at the center of the three flowers. And now I'm ready to put my little box together. For that, again, I'm going to use my bone folder. I'm going to reinforce all the scoring lines. Again, I'm going to add some double-sided tape on the flaps, glue at the bottom, and slide those two pieces together. Now, to embellish it, I combined some dies to cut out those two tags. You can stick the pink one on top of the white, and they already have a hole on top. However, I decided to let them loose. I don't want to stick them together. I like how they are going to move as I'm going to thread them through this white string. The pink tag says to you, and I think it is just adorable. And here are some close-up photos on this little party bug. For the third gift bag, I'm going to use the one with the rectangle handle, and on the side I'm going to place inside this little die that helps you squeeze the top. So I'm going to turn it around, I'm going to use some washi tape and keep those two dies together. And I'm also going to secure this die at the top, again with washi tape. This way, those two dies that I combined with the main panel are not going to move on me, and I will be able to cut out two identical pieces. And the die that I am securing now is going to give you an area where you can thread some string or ribbon to keep your bag closed. So I'm going for a more masculine color combo for this bag. I again combined two of the ties and a panel and another one on the inside. I'm using my Nouveau Deluxe glue at the back, and I'm going to stick that on one of the front panels. Now I'm going to slide it all the way towards the bottom since I already cut out those two holes at the top. And you already know how easy it is to put those two bags together. Some double-sided tape on the flaps, some glue at the bottom, and then again slide one on top of the other. I did use two of the dies to create a little tag. I'm going to stick one on top of the other, and the one that I'm going to stick on top has an embossed word that says two. Now, since I'm going for a more masculine design here and I combined blue with craft, I'm using some thread and I'm going to thread it through and tie a knot at the back. You can do that at the front, but I don't want to have any bows or anything. That's why I'm tying a double knot at the back, and you won't be able to see that. You can see that you can squeeze the top just because I used the die on the sides. Now I am also going to stick down that little label, and I did thread through some of the same twine. Here are some close-up photos on the third little treat bag, and notice the beautiful panel with those lovely birds on top. With all these interchangeable panels, the possibilities are endless. You will have lots of fun playing and creating different looks, make different die combinations, play with color, and bring in your specialty paper for amazing results. So these were the projects for today. I hope that you had fun, that you got inspired. Just like always, you will find links down below to everything I used. Thank you all so much for watching, and I'll see you all next time.